October the 8th, 2024. Guys, we've got the latest updates coming in from the National Hurricane Center. And what I've noticed throughout the day is a lot of people were saying that after it weakened overnight before it started reforming and it weakened down to a very strong Cat 4, most people were saying it's going to remain a 4 and then a 3, then a 2 and on through there. But with that much distance and with that much room for natural occurrences to happen or any other occurrence to happen, I doubt it very seriously. There's a lot going on, guys, and it's going to take another video to get in depth about that, but I want to show you a few things. It's back to a Cat 5, by the way, and the next movement is going to be a Cat 5. I'll show you those details, but let me show you the new tracking information. We had been bouncing around for the last few days. It was going to come into Tampa Bay. But now, this is the latest information right here. Check that out. Anyway, what they're going to be, we're going to be dealing with is right here, and that's maximum winds 110 knots. That puts us at 127 miles per hour. Now, a Cat 4 starts at 130, so we're just under 3 miles under a Cat 4 coming ashore. I think there's, I don't know if it's intentional. I don't know, especially with mainstream media. Don't know. But there's the point before it comes ashore, again, at 3 miles under a Cat 4. But the gust at 135 knots, that's 155 mile per hour. So the gusts are going to be 2 miles below a Cat 5. Very strong. And it's dropped back down. Notice where Sarasota's at. See that? And the second marking coming out of the computer printouts, and that's how I made this map using Google Maps, is right there. There's Melbourne right here. There is June Park. You can see that. Satellite Beach again. Everything's moved back to the south slightly. Now let's draw a line between the two. Let me set this up on the map, and we'll go from this point that's just below a Cat 4, according to that, to right here. I'll just extend it through so we'll have a full thing. Now, coming up to this area, guys, you're going to be dealing with a Cat 1, very strong Cat 1, with Cat 2 to Cat 3 gusts still, and then out into the Atlantic that way. But let's pull it up while we got that. Here's Bradenton, Longboat Key, Sarasota. It puts this side into the very bad section of the storm. Siesta Key, if this stays there, coming in as they're thinking 3 miles under a Cat 4, then you're going to have big troubles. And just again, let's zoom up with the line there. Again, Sarasota is here. Micah City, if that's how you pronounce it, I'm not sure. Coming up here, this is frostproof. Fort Meade is there. This is across the Three Lakes Wildlife Management Area. And it's coming out between Palm Bay right there and Satellite Beach. Again, this has been drifting each day, but each day we're narrowing down this path. Remember that. We only have tomorrow. You've got, again, the Satellite Beach here, Palm Bay here. Palm Bay, if this thing stays the way it is, you're going to be catching a Cat 1 with Cat 2 gusts, maybe a little stronger as it comes across. I've noticed something happened today on radar. And the storm suddenly sped up in forward speed and went back to a perfect eye very quickly. You want to take a look at that? Now, this starts out this morning. You saw some of this in the earlier video. You saw the center collapse, and then we talked about it was going to start reforming. Even Fox didn't think it was going to do that. I was watching theirs. It was going to stay a 4, then a 3, then a 2. But just watch it, and you're going to see it suddenly increase in speed, both inside the circle or as far as the center circulation, and it's moved to the right towards Florida. So I'm looking for the later update coming in 7 or 8 o'clock to give us the information on an increase in forward speed. But guys, this thing jumped back to a Cat 5 pretty quick. Now, I'm just going through some filters because I got something I want to show you. You've seen these before, but this is thing, guys, back to 167 miles an hour. That's sustained winds, strong Cat 5. But let's just watch it go through a couple times. Look at that. You can see the ocean down there. It's so clear. Now, right there, something happened. There was a flash. I'm going to come back to that. I'm going to show you the flash on this section. There's that flash. Now watch as we change filters. After that flash, and again, that's just one other section catching it. Now change the filter. Did you see that flash? Now watch the sudden increase. On most of the satellites, you can't see this. There's several of them you can watch. I'm going to go slower and slower. There it was, and then I'm going to stop it on the flash. So check this out. Going very slow. You see that? Now watch, it's going slower than normal. Suddenly, everything changes in the storm. I expected it to get back to a 5, but it did it very quickly. Now, will they be wrong about it coming ashore as a 3? Like I said, it's only 3 miles off from a 4, but watch that. Just check it out. Now, here's the pause. The entire Gulf lit up for that split second. And it's interesting that the timing is... It also had another flash, and the timing is very close. I don't know if the hurricane hunters were in that area or was it something else. But we'll just watch it again coming in here. Bam, right there now. I didn't change the speed of what we're watching. But that's what happened after it. Now back it out, and let's look at the entire Gulf region. There was the flash. You see it? Then we have that increase. So it was a wide blast of whatever it was. I've watched all of these a long time. I've never seen that happen. It usually you see it change when it goes to daylight. It gets a little brighter, but that's not what happened here. It was a sudden flash, went back to the original settings, and now look at that eye. Again, I thought that it would increase. I see right there now. I'm going to back this thing up. This is the visible satellite that we watch. It's one of the infrared settings. And you wouldn't have caught that square unless I think something happened at that point. Let's back it up right there. The timing is at 1346. Right at almost the same time. It was 13-something UTC time that the flash happened on the back, on the red one right there. Look at that, 1346 there also. And guys, in last night's video, you saw Comet Atlas. It was coming in front of the sun. Looks like it's diving into it, but it's not. It's going to cut in front of it. It's just the angle of the cameras. And I'll show you the JPL models in the next video. But it's very interesting because the flash that you saw as the comet was approaching the sun turned out to be an X2 flare, I think it was. We'll look at it closer in the next video. And we are going to get a glancing blow from that reaction to the comet. But in the video today, as I recorded it, there were two more flashes right after that initial burst as the comet was getting closer. And they were a part of that. It was a filament release that scanned probably a 25% of the surface of the sun. And in the next video, we're going to check the latest JPL because it showed the initial coronal mass ejection giving us a glancing blow to our planet, but it did not at that time, did not have time to have tracked possibly the Hyder flare that was behind it. And they're calling it actually 2X flares, but it was a very strong explosion. We'll be updating that. We're going to update the hurricane coming in. So everyone, please heed these warnings. This thing is going to be so life-threatening. The people that are staying may even in the three-story levels. I hope they're not on the ocean side because it's going to blow all that glass out. But then they could be trapped very easily with no power, no food. And I guess it's not a mandatory evacuation. I've seen them when Katrina came in. It was in Biloxi because we were there to film it. We had to leave. They forced everyone out. But don't play with this storm right here. I'm glad they forced us out. Let me say this because I think it approached these type speeds. And they said it came in as a Cat 3. We were 120 miles inland as it tore through New Orleans and the Gulf Coast. And we had 120 mile per hour sustained winds just south of Jackson, Mississippi. It was devastating to so many places. Again, we, you know, no power, no water for a couple weeks. But this thing's going to come in all the way across Florida and possibly be so close to a Cat 2 as it comes out on the other side, just south of Cape Canaveral, that you're not going to want to play with it. There's going to be so much power out. Guys, if you make it through the storm, if you're brave enough, or maybe not brave, maybe just have never been through anything like this, if you live, you'll never do it again. But if you make it, what are you going to do then? The roads are going to be closed. If your vehicles are parked, they're not going to be up on the third floor with you, or second floor, whatever. And so what are you going to do then? You're going to force people to come in, risk their lives, men and women, and to try to rescue you because you're not listening to these warnings. Please heed them. Save your lives. You can always come back and rebuild, or rebuild wherever you want to. But you cannot get back a loved one or yourself once that happens. And you don't want to leave your family because you were just being hard-headed, right? If you know friends or family, please share this video. As with any video I do, you can always share it, show the whole thing. You'll never get a copyright strike from this channel. We're watching it. Watch for the updates. It's a heads up. Be safe. Creation. This flash, I'm not so sure about that. But I'm going to